Kaviraj, thank you for being here.
You're welcome.
I want to ask you, how do you describe Kaviraj?
How do I describe Kaviraj? Kaviraj comes from Kavi, either poet or healer. Raja is Indian for king, king of healers.
Mm-hmm.
It was a title my guru gave me at some point. There was one sannyasi in our ashram. He was always very grumpy, very critical, like this, raspy voice, you know. And so one day I said to him, hey, look, you know, it's better that I give you some medicine. So then it will calm down a great deal. And he said, yes, please. So I gave him the medicine. And that same day, I had a discussion with one of my other guru bhais about a philosophical point, and we couldn't figure out who was right. So he says, we shall ask Guru Maharaj tomorrow. So next day, he's saying, Guru Maharaj, Kaviraj, you say so and so. And my Guru Maharaj goes, Kaviraj? Who? What Kaviraj? He goes, well, Vaikuntana. How is he a Kaviraj? Well, he says, maybe you should ask Sagar Maharaj.
Yeah.
So my guru goes, Sagar, are you there? And his voice had changed, and his face was relaxed, and he was very mellow. And he said, yes, I am here. He gave me a medicine, and now I have become a very sweet person. And then my guru said, oh, for so many years we have tried to turn you into a sweet person, and we could not succeed, and he is done overnight.
Yeah.
Then Kaviraji is.
Wow.
Yeah.
Nice. I want to talk about Dr. Hahnemann himself.
Yes.
Back in those days, doctors were more philosophers, meaning that they had a knowledge of science, they had knowledge of music, they have knowledge of biology, life.
Yeah.
Hahnemann himself, he had a perfect knowledge of chemistry.
Yes.
He made many discoveries in chemistry.
Mm-hmm.
He was a perfect chemist.
Yeah.
He knew music, he knew the art of dance, he was compatible or in tune with harmony of nature.
Yes.
And with Hahnemann, truth was the most important thing in his life.
Yes.
And when we talking about truth, there is no compromise in that. Now, in politics, sometimes, depending on the nature of the politics, it's good to have some compromises. But in truth, there's only facts. And Hahnemann was fighting for it for so many years.
Yes.
Now, my point is that Hahnemann was not just a simple doctor. He was a philosopher. However, we see that now there are groups that they have no information, no knowledge, they are not philosophers, they are not sometimes even doctors. And they are messing with homeopathy and they are trying to reject homeopathy. Do you think they are suffering from a kind of mental constipation?
Yeah, maybe. I would rather say they are suffering ignorance, which is the biggest problem in the world.
Yes.
Yeah. Ignorance in itself is not really a problem, but if you bring your, you know, you go to school and you know yourself to be a fool, and then you learn other people's ideas and you have to put that into your foolery, yeah, and so then you become only a bigger fool, yeah.
Yes.
It is not removing your ignorance. Yeah, because what we learn in school is not really knowledge. It is only a bunch of facts. We are not taught to think in school. Yeah, we are not taught to use the intelligence. We are only taught how to use a memory bank. And if you remember well, then you get high marks. Which is, well, you know, okay, some people have better memory than others, so those who have a good memory get all the high marks, but it doesn't mean that they are intelligent. It still means, you know, you can be, you can know so many facts in your memory bank and still be as ignorant as ever.
Yes. As a homeopath master, as a homeopath individual,
mm-hmm.
how many clinical studies, established clinical studies, scientific facts you have?
I have on homeopathy, yes. I have about 500 studies on humans,
mm-hmm.
450 studies on animals, about 120 on plants, and the rest is either preclinical or material science.
Yes. Yeah. Now, for laymen, for someone who has no idea what homeopathy is,
mm-hmm.
and to them, the best scenario, the best option would be to provide them with scientific and clinical results.
Yes.
And we have this information on hand, mm-hmm. thanks to more than 200 years of history,
yeah.
successful treatments.
Yeah.
When you have these and you provide them, they yeah. still ignore the facts.
Yes, and he who ignores is mm-hmm. ignorant.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
That is the result. If you ignore something, that means you are ignorant.
Yes.
So, no matter how much they like to present their ideas as being correct and mm-hmm. say, oh, there's nothing to do with it, or ignore things.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, I keep telling them, if you ignore something, you are ignorant.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yeah.
If you are ignorant, what are you talking about? You have proper study done of homeopathy. You have no clinical experience. You have no understanding of its scientific underpinnings, and you come here and you want to tell us what is right and what is wrong. Yeah. First of all, you know, in primary school, well, not primary school, in high school, in mm-hmm. your science class, you learn that matter cannot be destroyed. So you cannot say something becomes nothing, because nothing cannot be conceived of. Even in a vacuum, there is still something. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah. A vacuum is a vacuum, and
yes.
that is something.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So,
absolutely.
Therefore, you cannot say something becomes nothing. That is not possible. It's impossible to make this statement, because E is mc squared.
Yes.
Yeah. As Einstein has abundantly shown.
Yes.
Yeah, so you cannot say that when matter disappears, then okay, there is nothing left. Then there is still the energy, because mass, yeah, which is
mm-hmm.
matter,
mm-hmm.
yeah, equals energy,
mm-hmm.
yeah, according
right.
to E is mc squared.
Yes.
So then, how can you say that the matter, when the matter is not visible, then there is nothing left? Yeah. Then there must be some energy.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So you cannot have any reasonable explanation
mm-hmm.
on how something can become nothing. And then they say, yes, but it is diluted out, because beyond Avogadro's limit there is no molecules left. But my dear friends, we are not talking molecules here. Avogadro does not apply.
Yes.
We are talking energy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And so therefore, Avogadro does not apply.
Well, you cannot acknowledge what you don't understand.
Also.
Yes.
Yeah.
And the notion that there is nothing in it.
Mm.
Let's say we go to a lab, a microbiologist, and
yeah.
ask him or her to look on the microscope.
Yeah.
And examine a grain.
Yeah.
He or she might say that grain,
yeah.
it might produce, that grain might have a chance to grow.
Yeah.
Or if you provide a crust, and they will say, yeah, it can be contagious or not.
Yeah.
But that technology, that microscope, is not
yeah.
able to tell us if aconite root,
yeah.
what can it be done,
what can it do no.
to a healthy human?
No. That is point one. And point two is that the principle of contagion,
mm-hmm.
yeah, which they are speaking about,
yes.
Show me the principle of contagion under the microscope.
Yes.
You cannot. But contagion is still there.
Yes.
Yeah. So they engage in logical fallacies.
Yes.
Yeah. The principle of contagion, if you use their way of reasoning, the principle of contagion cannot be seen, so it is nothing.
Mm-hmm.
So it doesn't exist.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, there is repeatedly,
nothing,
yeah,
there
they
is
say
nothing
when
to
we
it.
Can, exactly. When,
yeah,
when
so then, and we know that mm-hmm. the principle of contagion mm-hmm. does exist.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so yes. therefore, yeah, how the principle of contagion works, nobody knows.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yes.
Nobody knows. And then they say, well, this is because of the germs. Oh, really? But if we look at the disease, say, for instance, we have the flu. In the flu, which is a viral disease, yeah, then you take a test of the stuff in the lungs, and then you see that one out of two or three cells has the virus there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, now I'm going to the doctor with a full-blown fact. I have the flu. And then my body is also full-blown full with virus. I have come to the doctor with the result, and the result is the virus. Result and cause, we learn in primary school already, can never be the same.
Right.
So then, how can they blame the virus to be the cause of the disease? That is not possible, because it is a result.
Yes.
Yeah? And if you die, then there is even more viruses in there. Yeah?
So, whatever we see on the microscope is the
yeah.
end result.
Yes.
It's not the beginning.
No.
They are looking at it from the last to the first.
Yes,
they
yes,
don't
yes.
looking at it from the first to the last.
No, they can't.
Yes. And what is astonishing is that the law of like cures like.
Yeah.
And vital force.
Yeah.
Is around even prior to Hahnemann and homeopathy.
Yes.
And Hippocrates
yes.
mentioned that in his book. Galen accept that.
Yes.
And in homeopathy, we are not rejecting pathology.
No.
I mean, a homeopath has the same knowledge of pathology,
yes.
biochemistry,
yes.
Medical science as anybody else.
Back to the notion that
yeah.
they are arguing.
Yes.
That there is no molecule in it.
Yeah.
There's no active ingredient in it.
Mm.
What do you have to say to that?
Well, they are right. There are no molecules in it. Because you see, when we grind up our triturations, yeah,
mm-hmm.
We take 1 grain to 100 grains of milk sugar,
mm-hmm.
yeah, and we grind it up very fine,
mm-hmm.
yeah, and then from that we take a bit and we do again with 99 grains of milk sugar,
mm-hmm.
and we do that a third time. By that time, the material yeah, has been ground up so fine
mm-hmm.
that what happens if you in nanotechnology, they also use superfine powders as they call them.
Mm-hmm.
The superfine powder there, the molecule has been made smaller than its critical length scale, which displays the normal properties.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and so because it is smaller than the molecule. Avogadro does not apply because Avogadro is the value for molecules.
Yes.
Yeah. So it has nothing to do with that.
Yes.
Yeah. A superfine powder
mm-hmm.
Is a molecule from which particles have been removed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What happens really is if when you grind it up, a crack appears
mm-hmm.
in the molecule.
Yes.
And also in the molecule of the lactose.
Yes.
And then the particle begins to grab into the crack, and the particle of milk sugar grabs into the crack into the substance, and so they become like one, and so the properties that are liberated by making a superfine powder then enter the lactose and become soluble in water. Yeah, so it has absolutely nothing to do with Avogadro. Avogadro does not apply because there are no molecules in that thing. There are nanoparticles in that substance. Yeah.
Yes.
And so the nanoparticle is smaller than a molecule.
Yes.
So it has nothing to do with Avogadro.
Exactly. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.